We're now going to define matrix powers and see some examples of computing matrix powers. Let A be an n by n matrix, and let K be a natural number. So K could be 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. Now we define A to the power 0 to be the identity matrix, and A to the power K to be A times A to the power K minus 1. So higher powers are defined in terms of a lower power. And from this definition, we see that A to the power 1 is same as A times A to the power 0 using this here. And A to the power 0 is I. So this is A times I. And that's just A. And what about A to the power 2, which we call A squared? That's the same as A times A to the power 1 using this again. And that is A times A, because A to the power 1 is A. And suppose I want to compute this matrix to the power 3. Then this is given by this matrix times the matrix to the power 2. And using what we have obtained here, I can write this as the product of two copies of the matrix. And if you work this out, you will get 1 minus 3. 0, 4 here, and so the final answer is going to be 1 minus 7, 0, 8. So in casual terms, A to the power K means you take the product of K copies of A. Now we can also define negative powers. If A is invertible, then A to the power K is also invertible. And the inverse of A to the power K is given by A inverse to the power K. And so we can define A to the negative K to be simply the inverse of A to the power K. So this is how negative powers are defined. So if I look at, say, something like this, to the power minus 2, it's the same as taking this matrix to the power 2 and then take the inverse. So the matrix taken to the power 2 is 1, 4, 0, 1, and then take the inverse, and then there will be 1, negative 4, 0, 1. As you can see from these examples, computing powers of matrices does not seem as easy as computing powers of numbers. But there are cases when matrix powers are relatively easy to compute, and that's something that we'll look at later on.